The Collective Awakening Event. Dear Ascending Family, as we enter phases of the breakdown in society as it is currently happening, it means that the energetic fields get more destabilized, and the outer conflicts and chaos increases. Many people are unaware that humanity is in an active war on multiple fronts. There is an active spiritual war being waged against humanity by non-human controllers extending to off-planet conflicts, and the parking lot of ET crafts sitting in the Kuiper Belt. Some of these groups are strong-arming the nations in Western cultures to collapse democratic or libertarian-based ideologies that support individual sovereignty in order to fall into the globalist slavery system of collectivism, via techno-totalitarianism. There are strange and unusual occurrences happening on these multiple dimensions of the planetary chessboard. These hidden events bring the high strangeness in determining what, if any, of these energetic impacts will be manifested on our timeline, or will those conflicts be neutralized and rendered invisible. I define neutralization of impacts to be that event or destruction that occurs during a false flag type of operation which goes under the radar in so that the majority of the population does not see or know what is happening. Most of us in this community should realize that we do not have an operating news media at this time. The mainstream sources of news are fully controlled propaganda machines run in coordination with military intelligence run by the controller groups. This makes this time very difficult, because we are being weakened by not having access to current information, or knowing the position of hot warfare when it is being carried out. As an example, sadly, all the statistics we are given about the bioweapon PSYOPs are largely manipulated and skewed, making it nearly impossible to tell what is what. Over the last few weeks or so, something else has been escalated in what feels to be some kind of strategic actions that are connected to some level of military-grade operation. I am not an insider nor have any connection to the military, but I can sense that there are military operations being enacted to another defensive stage on the East Coast, and what I can define as strategic chess moves occurring in the midst of these end-time battles. The battle is spiritual, as well as psychological, and as many of us may attest, the level of evil trickery, gaslighting, and lies being told to the masses are beyond anything we can adequately describe in words. In the distance, March 2022 is still hovering as a milestone point in the timeline which opens up directions in which many of us can begin to move forward with our lives. For many of us right now, it feels that we are being held hostage in a strange situation of wait and see, held in void of nothingness. Some of us may feel isolated, imprisoned, and immobile, while many people around us still do not register that we are in an active war that is raging against everything that is human. As it has been mentioned several times, this is the time when we will suffer casualties in this war. People, place, and things can come apart at the seams, because they have no idea what is happening, and they are believing the propaganda streams of lies and deceit. If we walk into the line of fire, we can get seriously hurt or be taken out. It does appear that when the time comes for the change and tipping point in the collective, it will have basic themes, and those themes are presenting this week as being escalated, so I am sharing this with you now. Many times the controllers take advantage of holidays and weekends to carry out operations that they hide from the public. Those that are supporting humanity, we can call them white hats, also tend to use holidays or long weekends to enact some kind of strategic operation. They are well aware of satanic holidays, full moons, and other ritualistic days. This year and with the holiday season feels to have much more weight behind it, with current operations happening in the field right now. There is a lot of military from multiple countries involved in a series of war games and supposed drills. This stage is wholly unpredictable, It is not possible to predict exact timing of collective events in the 0.0 time spaces. Only God knows when this is happening, and, it is in divine timing of a plan, we are not abandoned, and we are not losing the war, although it can appear this way. The biggest challenge we all have is the immense grief of those people we love and care for being taken in by the darkness, deceit, and lies, and that many hurt themselves when believing these lies. Although when, and, if they leave their body, it will be in a much better space, as it will be a briefing life review and release of the mind control suffered on this reality plane. At this point, it is hard to tell what can be enacted to neutralize the effects of the bioweapon, as we are seeing many benevolent actions and clearings happening en masse. I feel this is to prevent large die-off of the injected population, but unsure of how much can be neutralized, and what needs to happen as many souls will choose to leave. The tipping point of shifting can happen anywhere between now and the first quarter of next year, which will be a big global type of event of some sort that is dramatic, cannot be hidden, and the mainstream population will see it and know it. Once it is out, the genie cannot be put back in the bottle, so to speak. Some heating up is happening now with this event. This is the important phase of the falling dominoes and wild cards, and noting that the controllers have been doing all they can to hide the truth, subvert this benevolent agenda, redirect, and distract the masses so they will not figure out what is happening, and who is behind all of the divide and conquer and bioweapon psyops. Those of us that can still think in the fog of war can see clearly the injection symptoms are the promoted variants. Themes that may or may not present themselves as a big event between now and March 2022, and ongoing surreal global events, such as declaring wars with other countries. The nuclear program in UK is called Trident with Poseidon craft, and it connects to the Red Cube system. This will be mostly for show out of desperation. If they pull this out, know that there will not be any type of nuclear event. Smaller false flag operations, black military intelligence run terrorism for distraction and cover. Collapsing of Western financial markets and currency. Sudden deaths and disappearances of world figures, celebrity types, royals, such as the Queen in UK. People we were told were dead are revealed to have been in witness protection and alive. Emergency broadcast system being directed from military base or space program crew from satellite military systems. Temporary shutdown of certain online services or internet access. Collapse and controlled demolition of controller structures, that is hospitals, medical system, airlines, travel industry, shipping supplies, etc. This may shut down supply chains in certain areas, such as in US we will not have access to certain goods or products from overseas anymore. EMP type of destruction or repurposing of some landmarks, such as the White House, Washington DC area. This area as a political capital is done. Awareness that many more people have been killed by the bioweapon injection than we are being told. They have been hiding deaths and cataloging who has received which vaccine lots. Genocide will be known, and those involved ultimately prosecuted by tribunal. 5D benevolent groups were notified of human genocide violations recently. They are deciding what to do about that. Secret space program coordinated disclosure of their existence in breakaway civilization, and the technologies they have, exposing the war against non-human entities, or demonic forces known as aliens. Human trafficking, harvesting for blood and body parts, organ trafficking, pedophilia, and child adrenochrome farms in underground bases, and bunkers, and off-planet supply. Existence of the deep underground tunnels and military bases that acted as cover for non-human demonic entities and aliens to prey on humans. Existence of underground cities used by the Luciferian bloodlines and nameless billionaires for hiding depraved satanic elite activities. Sudden implementation of new technologies, or radical changes that impact society as we know it. Fall of mainstream media, and invasion, and slash or breakdown of Israel. It may be important to note here that, I am not political, since my youth I have despised politics in a satanic corrupt system, and thus we do not vote. We both despise the intentional harming, and torturing of humans, and life forms. My information comes from fieldwork from over 20 years when reluctantly asked to look at world events in energetic terms so that, I can see what is happening in detail, and help the founders when they ask. I was rudely awakened by them to correct my thinking when they told me that the U.S. Constitution is energetically linked to the law of one, the natural laws of God. They made it clear that, it is for that reason, the U.S. is important strategically in this spiritual warfare as well as global warfare against the controllers. These are the hand-picked bloodlines, and aliens working at the top of the pyramid of global control. We must remember that many of these people running this negative alien agenda look human, but they are not. They are the ones put in control by their superiors to farm humanity for their kind. As miserable as it can be at this time watching the harm and devastation that is happening in the world at large, and the fact humanity will have to recover from PTSD from all that has happened plus living through a real-time genocide, humanity does prevail late in a much better timeline where the truth is able to be spoken, and we regain our freedoms. As we hit the holiday season, it can get stressful, and the outer events will seem even more crazy, if that is even possible. Thus, do your best to not take the negativity inside your heart, and keep your focus on spiritually strengthening yourself, asking for guidance, and acting upon it, setting intentions for how to be of service after we go through this big event. As the society breaks down, some of us are slowly building our personal pieces to prepare for what is coming, and how we can best be of service to support humanity. This may be as simple as picking up pieces of broken family relationships, or helping people understand these changes, and what is happening on the earth during the ascension cycle. Some will not be willing to change, and that means they will have to be let go, as there will be no going back. It is adapt to the changes, or time to leave. This is a complicated topic of which I have spoken about in snippets through many different classes, or newsletters, but many hear that, are new or may not have heard, or read the previous information. Please do not allow fear into your mind over this information. It is the time to clear fear, quiet your mind, and develop your relationship with God, and Christos. God, and our beloved Christos family have our back. They are working very hard at our side, and there are many mysterious things happening that are blessings to help us all potentially experience miracles. Do not succumb to the fear-based narratives of what it looks like on the outer, as it is not the truth. There are many good and positive things happening for humanity that we cannot see on the outer yet. It will come in divine timing, and this shift will bring us to explore a new society, so we will need to be flexible, adaptable, and connected to our heart and God's Holy Spirit. Your intention to connect with God and have a good loving heart is enough. Use common sense, listen to your loving inner Christos spirit, and do not give up. We are almost there. Love, and GSF or God Sovereign Free. Lisa Renee.